everyone, so my name is Elizabeth and today I'm going to be talking about the books I read this past August. And I just want to say it was a great month. July was a really good month too, but like this month I loved all the books I read this month. I was not disappointed. I don't think I was disappointed in July either, but I read a lot of favorites. It was really good. It was a really good month. So this is the first book I read in the month of August. This is Queen of Air and Darkness by Cassandra Clare. If you guys haven't seen my review, go check it out if you've read the book. If you haven't, then there really isn't a reason for you guys to check it out. But I loved it so much. I gave it a 5 out of 5 stars. I know some people keep saying like, oh, this book, it's not like as plotty, I guess, like the plot isn't as amazing as Lord of Shadows or some of her previous books in this series, but I loved it so much just because the rest of the series is building up. Like in the first book of the series, which is Lady Midnight, we get to meet all these characters and we set the plot, kind of the story arc for the whole story. And then in the second book we get to like develop some kind of relationships between the characters and like hint at relationships and all these things. And then in this book we get to see the payoff of all that. We get to see characters come together. Sure, some of the relationships are like not, they're left off in this like place where it's like, oh my god, give me the wicked powers. But I adored this book so much. I enjoyed just seeing everyone in this book. Like you get to see so many characters of the Mortal Instruments and even the Infernal Devices, and it's just, it's my baby. I love it so much and I can't wait for the Wicked Powers. So that was the first book I read this year, I mean this month. And then the second book I read, I don't have anymore because it was a library book, but it was Skyward by Brandon Sanderson. It's about basically about Spensa and how her father deserted during a fight, and he was a pilot, and in the society being a coward or running away instead of fighting is like a big no-no. It's like the worst thing you can do, and she's labeled as the coward's daughter and she has to live with that title hanging over her head. And she gets into this pilot school and she's trying to become a pilot. There's more to that obviously, but overall I really enjoyed the book. I thought it was a great starter to the series. I wish I could have felt more connected to the characters. Maybe it's because I just read Cassandra Clare and like I'm always connected to those characters. Like I live and love for them. But with these characters, they were great characters. I didn't feel as connected to them, which is like the first book, which is understandable. So overall I gave that book 4 stars. I'm really excited to see what happens in the story overall, so I will be picking up and probably buying the second one because I did really enjoy it and I kind of want to add it to my collection. This is just a note, I guess, if you guys are looking for like romance in this series, Skyward, I would say there's like a hint that there could be possible romance in like the future books, but there is no romance in this book. It's very much about Spensa and following her journey and seeing her arc as a character. I did really like her arc as a character at the beginning. I didn't really like her as much. I thought she was really like just really in your face, like I'm tough, I mean, I get what I want and I'll work hard for what I want, which is, I normally like a person who works hard for what she wants, but she was very much in your face type of gal and I didn't enjoy that. And then but towards like, you can see how she's growing and how she is allowing herself to feel more, and I really did like that because it makes her more human. And yeah, overall I really really liked it. And I, after reading the book, I was like, I kind of want to be a pilot. I want to fly, I want to do all these cool maneuvers in the air. So yeah, overall I would recommend it. I gave it 4 stars. And yeah, okay, after reading Skyward I decided to pick up a book that I had ordered recently, and everyone, it's like all the rage. It was all the rage last year, and like the second book is like all the rage this year or earlier this year on BookTube. Basically the book I picked up was The Cruel Prince by Holly Black, and I started reading this book and I finished it in like 24 hours. I was just so addicted. It's just like so addictive. The series overall is a very addictive, because I'll tell you guys more why I think that and how I experienced that myself. But basically this book is about this girl, her name is Jude, and she and her sisters have been taken to Fairyland after her parents are killed by this guy, and this guy actually takes them to Fairyland, and which is not a spoiler, it's like in the first chapter. And I thought her character is very interesting because I feel like if I would have been taken to this world, I would have very much wanted to leave this world. But no, she grew up in this world. She was, I think, 10 or 9 when she first came into this world. This is all she's ever known. known. She wants to make people recognize that she is important, like she matters. Even though she's not a fairy, she still matters, and she's such a badass character. She's so smart. Some of the things she does, I'm just like, oh, I wouldn't have thought of doing that, but you did it, so kudos to you. And for me, this whole book, or like this whole world, is a bunch of characters who are grappling for this power, and they're all trying to outsmart each other. And I think that's one of the most addictive qualities about this book. Like, you want to see who's going to win, you want to see who's going to outsmart who and how they're going to do it. Also, along with this book, coming into this book, I knew that a lot of people, you know, like, love Cardin. Well, I've actually had two experiences that you either love him or you really don't like him at all, and you kind of don't want Jude with him. And I honestly, at the beginning of the book, I didn't want him, but then like as it goes on, there's just like so much sexual tension, and honestly I think he's kind of like a softy. I mean, he's still hard and he's still like cruel, but like there's dimensions to him, like you can see kind of why, which I found it kind of nice. Like, there's a reason he's like this, which people would say like, oh, there's a reason like all male characters who are like the bad boy type and who like mistreat the girl are cruel. But like, honestly, in this world I can see why someone would be cruel. I think I would even be jaded in this world. So that's The Cruel Prince. I gave it 4.25 stars. So because I loved it so much, like halfway reading through that one, I decided to order the second one, but it wasn't going to come in on time by the time I had finished this one. So I even bought the ebook, because, and I ended up reading mostly the ebook instead of the book, the physical book, which is The Wicked King, which I loved again. It's like a soap opera, like you don't know what's gonna happen, there's so many plot twists, and I just enjoyed it a lot. Some people didn't really like this one. I loved it a lot. I think some people think like, oh, the romance in this one is like heavier. I don't think it's heavier. I just think the characters are exploring more like this attraction they might feel for each other, or like this lust they might feel for each other. And also I think you just get to see the consequences of The Cruel Prince, and I really liked seeing that. I enjoyed it a lot, and like the ending, I actually have a spoilery discussion for this. I haven't uploaded it because I haven't edited it, because I don't know if like I'm gonna want to do it, post it out there for you guys. But I enjoyed it so much. I gave this one 4.5 stars because, again, I enjoyed it a lot more than the first one. And then the last two books I read this month, which I'm so excited, even though I've read them before, I needed more Shadowhunter World in my life. And for some reason I was like, I'm gonna just do it, I'm gonna just pick up Clockwork Angel and The Infernal Devices. So a reason I didn't want to pick up this series was because I cried a lot at the end of Clockwork Princess. This series really just grips my heart and just rips it out my chest and just stomps on it on the floor. It's just, it hurts, basically, what I'm trying to say. That's what I'm trying to say. I tabbed it, I annotated it. I love this book so much, and I love this book so much, and here are my babies. And literally while I was in school, I kept replaying all of the book scenes in my head because I can't stop thinking about them. I can't stop thinking about what they all mean to each other. How, I just ship the like triangle so hard, and I want them in my life. And I know what you guys are wanting to know. Whose team are you on? Okay, so like Will is like at 52 or like 54, and then like Jem is like at 46 or 48. Okay, so Will got me in this book when I found out that he loved reading and how he can like quote books. I fangirled so much when they were talking about books, even though I haven't really read A Tale of Two Cities. I want to now, I really do. And I love them so much. I love them both. Like, how can I not love Jem? He's like such a sweetheart, he's so nice, he plays the violin, he has the most like beautiful quotes. Like, a lot of the quotes I tapped are his quotes, because he has a very beautiful way of speaking, very beautiful like way of seeing the world. If I could trade places with anyone in my books, it'll probably be Tessa, because I love Will, I love Jeb, I need him so much. I don't think I'm going to be reading Clockwork Princess anytime soon. I think I'm going to leave it for like when I have a break from school, because I really need to like mourn these characters, and I'm gonna cry, and I'm just gonna be a mess, and I'm just gonna be so heartbroken, and I'm not gonna be able to focus on anything that's not them. So I think what I'm going to be reading, or hopefully what I want to be reading in September, it's kind of like a TBR, but not like really. So the book I'm currently reading right now is Lock and Key by Sarah Dessen. You see, I got this book for $1, and I don't really read contemporary, but so it's one of my friends like favorite books, so I want to read it. And I've just had it, and I've just, it's a pretty cover, it's interesting. Also, I want to read oh my god, okay, is anyone surprised? Of course, I want to read City of Bones because I'm trash for Cassandra Clare. Yeah, there's not much to say on that. I'm gonna annotate it and it's gonna be a fun ride. But then after that, hopefully I'll be picking up Prodigy and Champion by Mary Lou. This is the second and the third book in the Legend series by Mary Lou. This is one of my all-time favorite series ever. I think like June and Day are like my first OTP. Their story is one of the most sad stories ever. Actually, I feel like I just love sad stories. It just hits me in the heart, and I'm a sucker for them, and I love them so much. And hopefully I'll be reading these two so I can just rereading them, so then I can read Rebel, which comes out in October. Also, I want to say that if you guys are looking for like a read along for Legend, I know Jananie from This Story Ain't Over is hosting a read along for these books. So if you're just thinking like, oh, I haven't read it, like I would want to read it with someone, do it this September. So I'll be linking down her channel down below and like with a video where she talks about it. And I hope you guys do read this series if you guys haven't read them, because I love them so much and she loves them a lot, and they're really good stories. And okay, well, so that's it for this video, guys. Those are the books I hope to be reading. Those are the books I read, and just leave down your thoughts below on anything you guys want to talk about, comment and whatnot. Oh, I gave obviously The Infernal Devices 5 stars because I love that series so much. It's one of my all-time favorite series. It might be my favorite series right now at the moment. Yeah, I think it is. I'll talk to you guys later. Please subscribe, like this video if you liked it, press that notification bell, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.